Please raise your hand. Thanks. The first presentation is titled Implementation of a VLDC Motor Observer Using the InstaSpin Platform by Axel Coronado, Alejandra de la Guerra, and Luis Alvarez. You have 15 minutes for your presentation. And 5 minutes for question and answer. You can start your presentation.
Okay. Can you see the presentation? Okay. Is visible the presentation or not?
Yes.
Okay. Okay. Should I begin?
Yes.
Good afternoon. My name is Axel Coronado, and I will talk about the article with the title Implementation of the VLDC Motor Observer Scheme Using the InstaSpin Platform. The co-authors of this article are Alejandra de la Guerra and Luis Alvarez y Casa. Well, this presentation is structured as follows. First, in the first section, the objective of this article and a brief description of the control and estimation algorithms are presented. In the next section, I will talk about the features of the experimental platform. Then, in the third part, I will talk about the microcontroller and the observed programming. After that, I will show some results of some experiments. And finally, I will present some conclusions of this work. Well, in recent years, the VLDC motor has become an alternative to DC and induction motors for variable speed drives in many applications, given its simple structure, high efficiency, and speed versus torque characteristics. Given the limitation of the Hall effect sensors normally mounted in these VLDC motors, well, these sensors give information only each electrical 60 degrees, it's a common practice to design an observer and an estimation scheme aimed to recover continuous velocity and low torque signals requiring more complex control algorithms. Well, in this diagram, this diagram shows the control and the estimation algorithm that we use in this platform. We use the field-oriented control algorithm. In this method, the control of the stator currents is performed in the DQ reference frame of the rotor by these PI controllers. Therefore, it's necessary to transform the measured currents from the three-phase static reference to the rotating DQ reference using the Park and Clark transformations represented as these blocks. Okay, the output of these PI controllers are the voltage in the DQ reference frame, and this voltage needs to be transferred back to the three-phase reference frame, and after that, needs to be modulated using, in this case, the space vector modulation technique. Finally, the signal controls are sent to the inversor that is connected to the VLDC motor. Well, the estimation algorithm that we tested is formed by a cascade connection of a linear observer and a differentiator. We call it Cloud. This is a somewhat similar observer by the same authors presented in the reference 14 in the article. Okay, we don't present the equations of the observer because we are in process of publishing it, but the objective of the Cloud observer is to estimate the angular velocity and to reconstruct a variable lumped disturbance in the rotor shaft of the motor. This disturbance is formed by the load torque and dynamics not considered in the system, for example, the Coulomb friction. Well, this observer guarantees the convergence of the estimation error to zero in finite time in absence of noise if the disturbance and its derivatives are bounded. The observer requires the measurement of the currents and the position each 60 electrical degrees. Well, the in-space sensorless fog by Texas Instruments are a three-phase motor solution that makes designing of motor control applications easier. These solutions are designed to reduce cost and development time. This package includes an observer, example programs using the field-oriented control, motor in the identification, and among other features. Well, we use the FAS observer. The FAS observer is named after the estimated variables flux, angle, speed, and torque. This FAS observer is built in the ROM in some devices and cannot be accessed. Nevertheless, we use this FAS observer as a means of comparison between the low torque estimated by our algorithms and estimated by the FAS observer. We did that because we don't have a torque sensor in the platform yet. Well, speaking of the platform, here's a picture of it. This part is the high voltage kit control, and here's the control card. Here is the VLDC motor used, and is coupled with an incremental encoder. This aluminum disc with known size and weight is used as an inertial load. And in the back of the motor, there are three Hall effect sensors mounted. In the next slides, I will explain in more detail some of these parts. Well, the motor. The Brushless DC motor that was used was the VLG34-4S from Anaheim Automation. In the table, you can see some of the parameters of the motor. Some provided in the datasheet, and others were calculated through experiments, for example, the viscous friction. This is a motor with a star-connected stator phases, sinusoidal back electromotive force, and four pair of poles. Well, the high voltage motor control kit from Texas Instruments has a three-phase inverter stage to control motors up to 350 volts DC, an AC rectifier stage to generate disabled voltage for the inverter, and isolated serial connectivity, and also is compatible with 100 pin cards from Texas Instruments. Okay, the sensors. As I said before, the VLDC motor has a three Hall effect sensors placed at 120 electrical degrees between each other in the back of the motor. These sensors are useful for a rough calculation of position and speed every 60 electrical degrees. And in addition, an optical encoder with a resolution of 2000 pulse per revolution is connected to the motor shaft. We use this encoder to obtain a precise position and velocity calculation, and we use these signals as a means of comparison. And finally, the platform has three shunt resistors for current measurement of each stator phase. Okay, well, the control board on the high voltage control kit is the low cost microcontroller F28069 Piccolo from Texas Instruments. This is a high efficiency 32-bit CPU with a floating point unit, which is capable of native single precision operations. And as already mentioned, the microcontroller has a built-in observer referred as FAST in the RAM. Well, originally the programs were called using the fixed point library QMAT because some of these microcontrollers compatible with the platform cannot perform floating point units. However, this library lacks some basic mathematical operators necessary for programming the cloud observer. For this reason, considering that this microcontroller has a floating point unit, we rewritten all the program using floating point. Also, before being programmed in the microcontroller, the cloud observer first has to be discretized. In this case, it was discretized using the backward Euler approximation. Well, this is a diagram that shows in a simplified way the operation of the code. As can be seen, it's divided into parts, one part called main routine and the other part main ISR or main interruption routine. In the main routine, initialize and configures the controller, initialize the interrupt vector, enable the ADC interrupts, disable the PWM, enable the global interrupts, and remains in an infinite loop until an interruption is detected. And when an interruption is detected, the main routine stops and the single part of the code is executed. In this part, the source of the interruption is identified, the ADC ports, the encoder, and the Hall effect sensors are read, and the estimation algorithm is executed. Also, it's decided whether to run the current and speed pay controllers or not. After that, the control signals are written in the PWM ports, and this ends the interruption routine. And the program is returned to the infinite loop in the main routine, waiting for another interrupt. Well, as a first approximation, the observer was tested in open loop with a sample time of 0.13 milliseconds. Well, the experiments. This section presents the results of two experiments designed to show the behavior of the cold observer and the fast observer with and without load torque. The cold observer requires that the load torque and its derivatives to be bounded, and we use an inertial load. Therefore, it's necessary to generate sufficiently smooth speed trajectories. That's the reason why we choose this kind of trajectories. Well, in the first figure, shows the estimated velocity by the encoder with black dashes, the estimated velocity by the fast observer, and the velocity calculated with encoder in blue line. And here is the error between the estimated velocity by the cloud observer and the versus the velocity calculated with encoder. In this figure shows the estimated load torque by the cloud observer and the estimated load torque by the fast observer. Well, the second experiment the flywheel was coupled in the motor shaft, and the velocity reference was the same as the previous test. Also here you can see the estimated velocity by the cloud observer, the estimated velocity by the fast observer, and the velocity calculated with encoder. And here is also the error between the estimated velocity by the cloud observer and the velocity calculated with encoder. And finally, here are the results of the estimated load torque by the cloud observer and the estimated load torque by the fast observer. You can see that despite the inertial load, both observers achieve a good estimate of the velocity with an average error of less than 2% compared to the velocity calculated with encoder. And although the shape and magnitude of the estimated torque by the observer is similar, we need to compare it with a signal of the torque sensor to be able to conclude something about the error. Well, the conclusions. Well, the results of the experiment shows that the experimental platform is useful for testing different estimation algorithms with an acceptable sample time. The relative error in the estimation with the cloud observer is less than 2% for speeds greater than 30 rads per second. And in addition, it is possible to compare the magnitude and shape of the load torque, although not accurately, until a torque sensor is available. We think that we can achieve better performance by changing the microcontroller to be able to use smaller sample times. And finally, one possible drawback of the instant speed fog solution is the fact that the microcontroller must be programmed in C, in Code Composer. One way to overcome this is to generate code using MATLAB Simulink, for example, to have an easier interface for control design. Well, this ends my presentation. And if someone has any questions, I'm happy to answer them.
Thank you very much for your presentation. Anyone has any questions? No? I have any question.
Okay.
Your ADRC observer is better than other design of the observer, for example, Leuenberger observer, a nonlinear observer, etc.
Yes. The cloud observer is a combination of a linear observer with a differentiator. What we are trying to do is to perform better than just the linear observer.
Mm-hmm.
That's why we combine the linear observer and a differentiator.
Mm-hmm.
And the objective of this observer is to not only to estimate the angular velocity, also we want to reconstruct the low torque. Well, the loop and disturbance. And the loop and disturbance is also the low torque.
Your ADRC observer is linear or non-linear observer?
It's a non-linear observer. It's a combination of two observers. It's an linear observer combined with a non-linear observer.
For example, the linear extended state observer is equal to the good ADRC observer, nonlinear observer. Nonlinear observer is complicated, no? For its implementation.
Well, it's quite, that's quite different, more complex algorithm, yes.
Yes.
Yes, it's more complex. The algorithm is more complex, yes, but we have better results with the combination of the two of the two observers, with the combination of in cascade of the linear and non-linear observer.
Okay. The microcontroller used for your implementation is good? Is necessary other?
We think it's necessary other gates. Microcontroller. Yes. We are working in other microcontroller in the same platform. This microcontroller is a microcontroller that comes with the platform, but it's not fast enough mm-hmm. to run algorithms to the sample time that we require. That's why we run this first test in open loop.
Okay. Delfino, the SP is good for implementation.
The Delfino.
We
have this and Delfino, the new microcontroller is the Delfino F2837-9D, I think.
Mm-hmm.
Delfino microcontroller that has two CPUs, and we are working with that right now.
Thank you. Anyone has any questions? No? Thank you very much for your presentation.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Following the second presentation, is titled FPGA-based accuracy mechatronics of the feed drive system will bow screw by Carlos Emilio, Jesús López, Fermín Marines, Sergio Vergara, y Víctor Manuel. You have 15 minutes for your presentation and 5 minutes for question and answer. You can start your presentation?
Yes, only one thing. I don't have permission to share my. Okay.
Yes. Okay. Thanks.
Okay, you can see the presentation.
Yes.
Okay. Hello, good afternoon to all attendees and the moderator of this conference, Jesús Linares Flores. Today I have the opportunity to present the following research work called FPGA-based accuracy mechatronics of a feed drag system with Wallace Group in the 2021 18th International Conference on Electrical Engineering, Computing Science, and Automatic Control, TCA in Mexico. I introduce myself. My name is Carlos Emilio Márquez García. I'm a graduate in Electrical and Electronic Engineering from UHAT. The names of the collaborators of this work are Jesús López Gómez, Fermín Martínez Solís, et al. Okay, let's start with the content of this presentation. As we can see as the first point in this table, we have the introduction followed by the mathematical modeling, description of the proposed control hardware, the results, conclusions, and reference. The introduction, okay. Today, technological applications are focused at the development of high quality products in terms of construction and performance. Science has evolved to such an extent that microscopic applications are now a reality and still represent an engineering challenge. Positioning stages are very important in the modern technology, useful in any applications that require device capable of offering high precisions in sub-micrometer ranges. For this reason, micropositioning system requires a control algorithm to perform the trajectories or position with high precision. The implemented of configured controllers in embedded systems provides the opportunity for validation, total control or customization, cost reduced, and accessibility. Our research has as its general objective development an experimental platform based on FPGA architecture for the position control of a direct drive system with Wallace Group. And why direct drive system? Because it produced the transmission of model torque to the output device. In this case, the output device is a Wallace Group, and they are directly connected. And the specific objectives are analyze the mathematical modeling and development of a hardware configured FPGA embedded control. In this case, we introduce our own design of the proposed PID controller for the system. This will allow us to demonstrate the efficiency and optimization of the control. This is the main approach of work. And following, we implemented a floating point discrete PID algorithm, simulation of mathematical modeling with the PID controller, obtained experimental results with the PID controller implemented, and comparison the results of position control. Feedback systems. The feedback system consists of an actuator and a final control element or output device. The actuator that will perform the control in our systems consists of a DC motor and incremental encoder, which will indicate in real time the position of the motor shaft. We have to optimize the energy consumption, so the motor will consume as much as necessary by PWM. Subsequently, the final control element is a a valve screw, which allow us converting the rotational motion into linear motion. The valve screw consists in two parts, the screw and the nut. This element offers a lower friction, which must be lubricated. For micropositioning system with high precision, valve screw are especially manufactured so that the screw pitch is smaller. The screw pitch. And the feed drive with valve screw is the most used driving mechanism to the long stroke trajectories, positioning, and high speed. The challenge of studying this type of systems arises when adequate resolution and accuracy must be obtained. And what about FPGAs? Also, the real name is the field programmable gate arrays. Inside it contained logic cells whose interconnection and functionality can be configured using descriptive language. In this work, we use the Intel's DO NanoCyclone 4 to development board. Regardless of manufacturers such as Intel and Xilinx, FPGAs have elements in common. When we configure this type of systems, we get the firmware. Thanks to this, we are able to use other FPGA chips. FPGA boards allow us to validate programs, and from them, we can design microcontrollers and microprocessors. FPGAs are also known embedded systems because they are a combination of computer hardware and software. They are configured to perform a specific task, and they can be inside in larger systems. These type of systems allow us to create IP cores. Okay, following the mathematical modeling, to obtain it, the lumped parameter technique was used. This technique consists of analyzing the entire system and relating its variables. The figure shows the structure design for the feedback system with valve screw. The system presents a kinetic energies, potentials, and Rayleigh dissipation functions that were obtained from the systems. In order to obtain the dynamic model, we use the Lagrange methods, which consist in apply this formula to the Lagrangian LT and the Rayleigh dissipation function. The Lagrangian LT consists in the difference of the kinetic and potential energies for the system. In the system exists 6 degrees of freedom, that 4 of them are rotational and 2 are linear. All these equations were used to simulate the behavior of the system with the PID controller implementation. This is the system using the Lagrange method. This is the controller. And the 6 equation following are the rotational and linear. The description of the proposed control hardware. Our system consists in two fundamental parts. The first, a user interface called LabVIEW. We use to send the controller gains. These are position and PWM frequency of the motor. The second, a low-cost FPGA chip is configured in AHDL language. It receives the information through a Wi-Fi module at about a rate of 460,800 bouts. The communication protocol implemented inside it was UART, which we only use the receiver for read the information. The information passes through a reception block that is responsible to correctly distribution of the parameters. Finally, the system is feedback to by the encoder's signals. In the control block, these equations were configured using mathematical methods, Euler derivatives and integral were used in this case. The error consists of the difference between the desired position and the actual position of the motor, or real position in this case. And T is the sample period. The simulation results of the mathematical modeling and PID control by the equations were compared with those embedded PID controller FPGA. As we can see in the first test, the experimental and simulation results are almost the same when they reach the final or desired position. We can see the velocity decreases asymptotically or smoothly to zero when the final position is reached. In this second test, our controller returns to zero position. So that is position. And finally, we have the third proof. And desired position was approximately 1 micrometer, and we can see that the system doesn't respond, but the encoder does. We can see this pulse. It demonstrates that the response of encoder configuration has a high resolution, so that the position pulse is reflected in the figure. However, the encoder configuration presents a favorable response in the processing and positioning in which it injects the necessary energy to move the encoder. But physically, it doesn't break the phenomena presenting in the model. In conclusion, the main aim of the study was to guarantee the maximum optimal performance with the methodology proposed of implementation in hardware. The objectives and contribution of this work were successfully achieved. We can see some reference, and thank you for your attention and the opportunity to present what we are developing as a team in UHAT. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Carlos Emilio. Anyone has any questions? I have a question.
Yes.
What FPGA gate is you use in your setup?
Okay, we use the board, the Intel's board, the DEO Nano Cyclone 4 is the chip used.
It's from
Intel.
What program do you use?
We use Quartus is the name of the program. It's by the Intels. Mm-hmm. And we use AHDL language because it's easily to identify or compare between C language and this type of descriptive language.
Okay. How do you design your PID controller? How do you design?
Okay. Well, we use the Euler integration and and derivation, and we use mathematical methods to implement this type of controller. Mm-hmm. And it was a discrete controller, yes, because we use a point floating in this case by 64 bits.
Okay. How you tune your PID controller?
Can you repeat the question, please?
How you tune your PID controller? What method for designed?
Okay. We use the
which method to other method for you tune controller.
Okay, we use the difference between the desired position and the real position. In this case, we see a difference, and we continue to developing another type of controllers, and in this case, we only validate the optimized of PID controller in FPGA boards. This allow us to optimization, accessibility. It's a good choice for experimental results and processes in the industry.
Okay. Thank you very much for your presentation. Congratulations, Carlos Emilio.
Thank you very much, too.
Okay. The third presentation is titled Rotor Position Estimation in a VLDC Motor, a Low Speed Using G Function and Extended State Observer. By author is Isaí Jiménez, Carlos García, and Jesús Linares. You have is 15 minutes for your presentation and 5 minutes for questions and answer. You can start your presentation, please.
Okay. Can you see my presentation?
Yes.
Okay. Good day, everyone. Welcome. As part of the 18th International Conference on Electrical Engineering, Computing Science, and Automatic Control, I will present you the paper named Rotor Position Estimation in a VLDC Motor, a Low Speed Using G Functions and Extended State Observers. Your presenter, Isaí Jiménez Hernández from the Universidad Tecnológica de Mixteca in Oaxaca, Mexico. The content of the presentation is the next. We start with a brief introduction to the subject. We will present the estimation algorithm we use, as well as the simulation platform we implement. We show the simulation and the experimental results with this method and the conclusion and future work we want to make. The VLDC motor or brushless direct current motor is a permanent magnet synchronous machine characterized by the trapezoidal shaped back EMF and the direct current power supply this kind of motors are very similar to the DC current motor, but this replaced the conventional brushes with an electrical inverter for the commutation of the windings. These kind of motors are a very good option in application of electric mobility, thanks that we can found in wheel configurations in some manufacturers. This in wheel configuration allows us to eliminate the power transmission systems in electric vehicles. The principal characteristics of this type of motors are the compact size, the minimum energy losses, wide speed range in this, the high power density, and the easy operations compared with other type of motors, principal the PMSM motor. In the figure one, we can see the BLDC base Segway type electric vehicle. This is a prototype that uses these kinds of in-wheel BLDC motors. Using this kind of motors, there are two approaches of operation. One of these is the sensored operation, where we can use the physical position sensors, named Hall effect sensors, encoders, etc. These sensors allow us to determine the commutation signals in the inverter stage. On the other hand, we have the sensorless operation. In this, we want to estimate the rotor position only by measuring the motor electrical signals, voltages, and currents. This kind of operation allows to operate the motor without the physical sensors that are mounted directly on the motor, and in some applications, there is no feasible to apply. The sensorless methods are classified by these five main classifications. Our method is based on the back EMF, but the other methods are based on the inductances, flux linkage, freewheeling diodes, and the intelligent estimation methods that use neural networks and artificial intelligence. Our principal motivation is that most of the commonly used sensorless methods presents problems at the low speed operation. All the methods, or most of the all methods we present in the classifications, presents errors in the estimation at the low speed. And this low speed is an interesting field of research in the sensorless area, especially when we talk of electric vehicles, where the low speed is necessary. The estimation algorithm we use is based on the G-function-based estimation method. These G-functions provide the stability in the estimation at low speed. The method uses only the measurements of the line-to-line voltages and currents in the motor. These equations of the G-functions are derived from the line-to-line electrical equations of the motor. The main idea of this method is explained on the figure four. The G functions added form the CCP signal. The G functions are asymptotic functions that presents overshoots in each one. Adding the G functions, we can make a CCP signal, name it that because zero cross point signal. And these CCP signals are directly related to the line-to-line EMF zero crossing points, as this shows the figure. These zero cross points are directly related to the Hall effect sensor signals changes. So if we got the CCP signal constructed by the G functions, we can make virtual Hall effect sensor signals to replace the real ones. The main equations are derived from the electrical circuit of the BLDC motor. These equations, for the example of this grid showed in the figure five, we can obtain the equation one. The equation two is a proposal of the line-to-line notation of the equation one. And the equation three shows the relationship between the line-to-line EMF and the angular velocity and the form function of the EMF, in this case, of trapezoidal shape. Once we have the equation two as it is marked, we can make the other two equations in the electrical circuit for EMF AB, BC, and CA, the different combination of this. If we have these equations of the EMFs, we can construct the G functions that are defined as the equation 4, 5, and 6. These equations are the division of the possible combinations of the EMFs that we derived before. These equations are independent, because the division of this caused by the equation 3, we eliminate the velocity term. So the G functions are only dependent on the line-to-line measurements of the voltages and currents, and additionally, we have the derivatives of the currents. This is the principal problem using these G functions, because the derivative term will present errors because the signal of the currents are noisy. So having this, we propose a method to eliminate this element of the derivatives. So using the equation 2 presented, we can rewrite this as the equation 7. If we define the equation 8 as the new variable C1, we can get the equation 9, where we have a first order differential equation of C1. If we have this first order system, we can propose an extended state observer, ESO. This extended state observer follows the dynamics of the equation 9. And the ESO proposed as in equation 10 and 11, where the new variable eta 1 represents the estimation of the line-to-line current, and the eta 2 represents the extended state and represents the estimation of the line-to-line EMF. If we construct three of these ESOs, we can obtain the three line-to-line EMFs that we need to the construction of the G functions. So using these proposed ESOs, we reconstruct the G function now based only on the line-to-line voltages and current, discarding the use of signal derivatives from the original method. For the simulation of this platform, we implement this in the MATLAB Simulink software. The principal blocks are the permanent magnet synchronous machine block that we configure to use as the VLDC motor, and the estimator block. The estimator block contains the three ESOs that we need to estimate the line-to-line EMFs. Once we have the line-to-line EMFs estimated, we divide them in the different combinations as the equation says, and we get the 3G functions. The implementation of the ESOs are simple and follows the equations of the ESOs. The principal results are the estimation of the line-to-line ESO EMFs. This EMF shows a trapezoidal shape that we expect, and we can see clearly the phase shifting between these and the zero crossing points in each one. If we have the three well-defined estimations of the EMFs, we can reconstruct the 3G functions. These 3G functions presents a perfectly defined overshoots that we need. If we add these 3G functions in only one signal, name it the CCP signal, we can compare this with the real Hall effect sensor signals, where each of the overshoots in the CCP signal is related to each of the changes on the Hall effect sensors. So having the CCP signal, we construct the virtual ones, signals of the Hall effect sensors, and we can operate the motor in open loop in this case. At 6 60 RPMs. And we can see the real position versus the estimated position. And we can see that it's are not equal, but they are similar. Additionally, we have the angular velocity chart. First, we show the difference between operation with sensors and without sensor or the sensorless operation. We can see that the startup operation are very similar, and both of them reach the same operating point set on the 60 RPMs. Additionally, we make a robust analysis of on parameter variation, this case on resistance variation, on the range of 50% of the original value to the 300% of this. The method works correctly in this range of variation, and it works, we can say that it is robust. For the experimental part, we have in figure 4 to the left, the 800 watts VLDC motor that we use, and this motor is the same kind of motors that used in the Segway type electric vehicle we presented in the beginning. To the right, we have the three-phase inverter we implement, and in the same PCB we have the three-phase inverter and the current and voltage sensors. The experimental result shows the estimated line-to-line EMFs. We can see that they are not perfectly trapezoidal, but we can see that they are phase shifted between them, and we can see clearly the zero crossing points in each one. If we use the three estimated EMFs, we can construct the 3G functions we need. Once we have the 3G functions that shows the clearly overshoots, we construct the CCP signal. This CCP signal compared with the real one Hall effect sensors shows the relationship between each of the changes on the CCP signal and the changes on the value of the Hall effect sensors. Once we have generated the virtual sensors, we compare this with the real ones, and we can see the time delay that exists between the two. This time delay of 2.8 milliseconds is due to the calculations of the digital device we chose. Finally, we have all the sensors, the virtual ones and the real ones, and we see the correspondence between them and the estimation and the real position of the motor when we run this at 35 RPMs in open loop. As the conclusions, we have that the proposed EMF observers improve the performance of the original methods, as well as the simulation and the experimental results shows the good performance of the proposed method. The operations in presence of resistance parameter variation in the simulation case only shows the good parameter robustness. And finally, the proposal is easy to implement in the DSP we chose. The future work we want to make is to improve the implementation of the ESOs to minimize the time delay due to the calculations. And we want to implement an initial position estimator in the sensorless scheme to fully accomplish the idea of the sensorless. Thanks for watching.
Thank you very much for your presentation. Anyone has any questions? No? I have any question. G function method of observation is better than other method?
It's better at the low speed operation. The other methods presents this problem at the low speed, and the G functions works fine at the low speed, but works fine too in the in the all speed range of the motor, mm-hmm. but the other methods are ones are or more easily to implement, but mm-hmm. the low speed that is our case, it is better.
There are many methods similar to G function method.
No, when there are the classification as that we show that I mm-hmm. show. There are other type of methods. Mm-hmm. In the same classification of based on the EMF methods, mm-hmm. there are various based on the measurement of the EMF signal. All of these are based on the zero crossing points of these signals. In this case, this G functions method is similar to the others, but the way the method estimates the zero crossing points is the difference. The others detect the zero crossing point by using other tools.
Okay. The standard state observer is very important in your design.
The ESO is our contribution to the mm-hmm. original method, because we want to eliminate the derivative of the current that the original method present. In this case, is the most important part of our collaboration. With this extended state observers, with mm-hmm. this we have the signals that we need to construct the G functions. So it's the most important thing I think in this proposal.
Okay, thank you very much. Anyone has any question? Okay, Isai, thank you very much for your presentation. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Thank you very much for your attendance at this Congress.
Thank you.
Thank you.